नेक्स्ट वन इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट, एथेनॉल मेटाबॉलिज्म और अल्कोहल मेटाबॉलिज्म। इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड अल्कोहल मेटाबॉलिज्म, फर्स्ट वी डिस्क्राइब हाउ अल्कोहल इज ट्रीटेड इन द बॉडी। सो एथेनॉल, वी हैव सबस्ट्रेट नोन एज एथा ईटो और एथेनॉल। द एथेनॉल इज यूजिंग एन ए डी पॉजिटिव एंड ऑल्सो अल्कोहल dehydrogenase enzyme in the cytosol to make aldehyde. This acetaldehyde or this aldehyde, this acetaldehyde is also formed in this, it happens into the cytosol. It is also formed in the microsome. In the microsome, the ethanol using NADPH and also using liver enzyme cytochrome P2E enzyme, ethanol plus NADPH to make this acetaldehyde. So first one is this pathway in the cytosol, also in the microsomes. There is another pathway by cytochrome P2E enzyme. Then we have another pathway ethanol uses. So ethanol is react with the catalase enzyme and uses in the peroxisome uses hydrogen peroxide and ethanol get converted into acetaldehyde. So there are three main ways to use this ethanol to make aldehyde. In the peroxisome, ethanol react with the hydrogen peroxide by the help of catalase enzyme to make acetaldehyde. Ethanol in the cytosol uses alcohol dehydrogenase to make, with the help of NAD positive, to make acetaldehyde. And ethanol also in the microsome uses NADPH to make acetaldehyde. This acetaldehyde over here we just name a line which is NAD positive is the limiting reactant in ethanol metabolism. So this is very much important. Whenever we deplete NADH, NAD positive, we just stop this ethanol metabolism. So there is acetaldehyde, there is a increased level of acetaldehyde, increased level of alcohol. So the symptoms are here. So what happened to this acetaldehyde? It goes into the mitochondria, and in the mitochondria, acetaldehyde, now we have acetaldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme with the help of NAD positive to make what? To make acetate. Over here is also NADH. So NADH positive is the main limiting reactant for alcohol metabolism. Whenever we get depleted from NAD positive, our body depleted from NAD positive, we cannot metabolize NA alcohol. So the alcohol remains in the body. So the enzyme which inhibit alcohol dehydrogenase is fomapizole, which is used in alcohol intoxication as a competitive inhibitor for alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme. And for acetaldehyde dehydrogenase, we give disulfiram, which inhibit dehydrogenation of acetaldehyde and increase the level of acetaldehyde to give the hangover like symptoms and to discourage drinking, and it is used in rehabilitation center. So over here is just the diagram to represent how alcohol metabolize in the body. how different pathways are involved, and it follows zero order kinetics. What does it mean? It means that there is a constant amount of alcohol which is removed from the body by metabolizing it. So if you take one shot, two shot, 1 liter, 2 liter, 500 liter, whatever the limit of the alcohol you are taking into the body, it just remain a constant amount of alcohol remains excreted from the body. So there is increased level of alcohol in the body, because there is a, it follows zero order kinetics, which means that regardless of the time, the constant, for example, 10 ml of alcohol is removed from the body per hour. So if you take a lot of alcohol, then the with respect to the timing, the constant amount of alcohol is removed from the body. So there is a prolonged hangover period, regardless you are taking a small amount of alcohol or a large amount of alcohol. So this is zero order kinetics. So two important MCQs over here: NAD positive is a limiting reactant, and zero order kinetic followed by alcohol metabolism. Fomepizole and disulfiram are used for intoxication and discourage rehabilitation center rehabilitation disorder. So now how this alcohol causing four important symptoms. First one is alcohol causing lactic acidosis. I will describe here. Second one is alcohol causing fasting hypoglycemia. It also causes ketosis, and it causing hepatic steatosis. Yes, so these are the four important symptoms which alcohol causes in the body. So first describe how this whole cycle is inhibited. We have glucose in the body. Glucose is converted into glucose 3-phosphate or glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which goes to the dihydroxyacetone phosphate. And in this pathway, whenever alcohol is metabolized, there is decreased level of NAD positive and increased level of NADH. So if we just combine this equation, we can say that we have increase NADH2, decrease NAD positive ratio. So this ratio is disturbed, which means that decrease NAD positive, increase NADH. This increased NADH is used by these four pathways to represent these all symptoms. So whatever we describe here is the effects of increase NADH and decrease of NADH. So if there is decrease NADH, we cannot metabolize alcohol, we cannot metabolize aldehyde, we cannot make acetate. So glucose is converted in glycolysis, glucose is converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which can interchangeable to dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Then also we can make PEP, phosphoenol pyruvate, and make our final product pyruvate. This pyruvate, it gives a acetyl CoA, and this acetyl CoA goes to the TCA cycle. So pyruvate dehydrogenase enzyme use NAD positive substrate to make this pyruvate uses NAD positive to make acetyl CoA. So whenever there is no NAD positive left, we cannot make a pyruvate, we cannot convert pyruvate to acetyl CoA. Rather, this pyruvate goes to the lactic acid dehydrogenase to make lactate. So
The bypass of this pathway is happened by the effect of increased NAD positive. So the effect of depletion of NAD positive is seen over here, that because of this depletion, the pyruvate cannot process into the acetyl-CoA level. We cannot make we inhibit the TCA cycle, so we can make the pyruvate diverge into lactate. So there is a lactic acidosis, which is a A9 gap, A9 high A9 gap metabolic acidosis. So in the patient presents with the lactic acidosis type of symptoms. So the increase in NADH can causing a lactic acidosis by increased pyruvate converted into lactate metabolite. Then this pyruvate dehydrogenase also uses P1 enzyme. So what I will describe in my previous lectures, that B1 is most important. So whenever there is alcohol intoxication or chronic alcohol disease, we deplete not only NADH but also we deplete B1. So if B1 is depleted, we cannot dehydrogenate pyruvate, we cannot dehydrogenate alpha-ketoglutarate. So whenever the body is in the fasting state, then whenever the body is in the fasting state, the body cannot do gluconeogenesis. So there is decrease, there is the body no gluconeogenesis. So what happened to the TCA cycle? We cannot use alpha-ketoglutarate to wheel this whole cycle. So no gluconeogenesis, the body in the fasting state is suffering from hypoglycemia. So no oxaloacetate is converted into phosphoenol pyruvate, no conversion, rather oxaloacetate. So there is decreased level of oxaloacetate. And this decreased level of oxaloacetate, we have discussed that in the TCA cycle, malate dehydrogenate to form oxaloacetate. But if TCA is inhibited, the remaining malate is the TCA is inhibited, we cannot use oxaloacetate. So in the reversal of this and in the excess of NADH, we use this NADH to make a lot of malate. So there is increased level of malate, there is decreased level of oxaloacetate. So now the body is under the fasting hypoglycemia. So this happens to the oxaloacetate, this happens to the gluconeogenesis and TCA cycle. So next, this is number one effect, this is number two effect. The next thing which we will discuss in here, that what happened to if we do not use this gluconeogenesis, what happened to this dihydroxyacetone, or what happened to this ketone body? So this ketone body is using NADH to make glycerol 3 phosphate, and we have known that this glycerol 3 phosphate is very much important substrate. This glycerol 3 phosphate is very much important substrate for the formation of fatty acids. So this is the effect. This is 4A. This is the effect for fatty acid synthesis, or which we have there here, that hepatic steatosis. So before diving into the hepatic steatosis, let's discuss how ketosis happen. So we have known that ketone bodies are formed by whenever we are in the prolonged starvation. Like here we are in prolonged fasting hypoglycemia or prolonged starvation. So then now our body is shifted from gluconeogenesis to ketone production or ketosis. So how this happen? The acetylcholine, which physiologically used by TCA, is now accumulated into the body,
and there is increased level of acetyl-CoA, and this whole acetyl-CoA is now shifted towards ketosis, increased level of ketone bodies. So we not only have lactate, we have also ketosis. So ketoacidosis or ketosis, there is increased level of ketone bodies. And this is also the diversion of acetyl-CoA, that acetyl-CoA is not used in the TCA cycle. Body is under hypoglycemic. So how body survive? By making ketone bodies. So the person is having ketosis. There is increased level of hydroxybutyrate. There is increased level of acetoacetate. There is acetone breath, which is in the person's which is very much used in the patrolling police, that they just smell that if the suspect has a alcoholic chronic alcoholic disorders, and then they just suspect that person and just smell their breath. So they have the acetone breath smell. So this is because of the ketosis, that it shows that the body is undergone prolonged starvation and ketosis. So this is one way of using that acetyl-CoA. But if we have a lot of acetyl-CoA, so how we use that? We use it like this. We use it by converting this ketone dihydroxyacetone phosphate to make glycerol 3-phosphate, and we also use acetyl-CoA to make fatty acid. So there is increased level of fatty acid synthesis. So we can use acetyl-CoA to increase fatty acid synthesis and decrease free fatty acid oxidation. We do not degenerate this as we do not degenerate free fatty acid, rather we increase level of free fatty acid. So if we combine fatty acid and glycerol 3-phosphate, we increase the level of TAG. That's why the alcoholic patients are very much fat or obese. They have a beer belly or whatever we can say that. So this leads to increased level of TAG. They can cause hepatic steatosis. So this is all the interrelatable changes from alcohol metabolism to lactate dehydrogenation. Then we have fatty acid synthesis, ketosis, then inhibition of gluconeogenesis and inhibition of TCA cycle. So this is all interrelated by the misuse of alcohol, or I would say that by the usage of alcohol, because in my preference, the use of alcohol is illegal, and it is recommended, it is by the regulatory authorities, it is inhibited. The alcohol making factories, alcohol making industry should be shut down to discourage the whole usage of, misusage of, or usage of alcohol in the public. So I strongly condemn the use of alcohol, because it is very much destructive for the human body. So this is how the whole alcohol metabolism happen. It not only alter the liver enzyme, overload the liver, it is also overloading other cycles very much. So this is how the alcohol affect our whole body. So I should advise all of my viewers that never ever go into this crucial cycle. Never encourage a teenager or anyone to use alcohol as a remedy or whatever the lifestyle. That always discourage the use of, live a healthy life, drink water, and never use these alcohol or alcohol related beverages. Always go for a healthy cycle. So these are the effect of alcohol on the whole body: lactic acidosis, fasting hypoglycemia, ketosis, and hepatic steatosis. So finally, the person is suffering from cirrhosis, and the end of the alcoholic patient is alcoholic liver disease. And that liver disease is very much devastating. That very much metastasized to causing pancreatitis, alcoholic liver diseases, kidney problems, eye problem. There are a lot of hormonal abnormalities. So the single mistake a person made during its life can causing a long term or long like effect. So this is all about alcohol metabolism and alcohol effects.